to je novi obraz Mercedesovih tovornjakov, novi Actros. In seveda vse to je polno, zato ker gre za električni tovornjak. In pri Mercedes Trucks pravi, da gre za game changerja. Trditev, da gre za povsem novo zgodbo, pa se nanaša na povsem nove baterije. Baterije, ki bodo spremenile tudi električna osebna vozila.
Cell technology is lithium iron phosphate, or short LFP. And the game changer of this is the cell chemistry is much more robust. So you can fully charge the battery and it doesn't age because of that. It's very long lasting. So after 1.2 million kilometers and 10 years of operation, it is presumed to be in a very excellent condition then.
Slabost današnjih baterij ni samo v tem, da so ključne sestavine redke kovine, nikel, mangan in kobalt, ampak tudi, da je z njimi treba ravnati previdno.
With the NMC technology, you want to leave on the top and on the lower area some free space to avoid aging. For the LFP, it's actually good to fully charge it. It doesn't matter if you don't charge it, but what happens is the voltage over the capacity of the battery is very flat. So if you charge we take out one cell, okay? The cell is totally empty, you charge it, the voltage goes up, and then in a wide range in the middle, it's very flat, and then on the end it goes up. The problem is, we look on the voltage of the cell to see how full the cell is. Now in the middle where it's very flat, we don't know out of the voltage how full the cell is. So we have to wait till it's full or empty to say, okay, this cell is full now. And now you have many, many cells, and each cell is a little bit different and is discharging over time a little bit different. So if you would remain always in the middle, the cells would spread, we call that cell spread. So they spread from each other. So once you charge the battery to the full, and then the first battery cell comes into the situation where the voltage goes up, then we realize, okay, now this is gonna be full, and then we can start balancing. And that's why we urge the customers actually to fully charge and not to only charge to 80% to save the battery. No, you don't do anything good for it. You can fully charge it and you can balance it. But a good note is also, if you would only charge it to 80% all the time, you have big cell spread, you don't have a good range, you just have to, for a while, charge it full again and then it will recover. The cells will balance and then everything's good.
Da bi bila raba električnega avta bolj enostavna, si želi marsikateri lastnik. Ampak LFP baterije še ne bodo tako hitro realnost v osebnem prometu.
In the passenger cars, you want to have a little bit more performance, so the top performing cars still go with NMC currently. And the robustness, of course, you know, with a car, it's about maybe 300,000 kilometers. This needs to last 1.2 million kilometers at least. That's how we develop our diesel trucks. And this truck has to go through the same testing, through the same procedures like a diesel truck.
V e-Actros 600 so vgradili tri pakete baterij, skupne bruto kapacitete 621 kWh oziroma neto uporabne kapacitete kar 600 kWh. Uporabnih je torej več kot 96%. Poleg tega, da liti železofosfatne baterije lahko do konca napolnimo, pa je njihova prednost tudi v tem, da jih lahko redno polnimo hitro. In to ne samo recimo s 350 kW, kar velja pri avtomobilih za super hitro, tovornjak polnimo mega hitro.
If you have a pass car where you have 80 kilowatt hours only and then you put 1 MW, then you know that's per cell a much wider load basically. So 1 MW is not so much for such a huge battery pack on the one side. The other thing is the LFP is more robust also against, like, if you have local overheating or so, this doesn't damage the surfaces. For the NMC, local overheating, then suddenly the surface is damaged and this surface is not reacting so good in the future anymore. And if you have many damaged surfaces, it ages basically and you won't ever recover that, you know. With the LFP, this doesn't happen so, yeah.
Mercedesova baterije so plod razvoja kitajskega baterijskega giganta CATL. To je točno tisto podjetje, ki nam je pred mesecem dni v Minhnu pokazalo LFP baterijo za osebni avto, ki zmore v manj kot 10 minutah povrniti za 400 km dosega. in ker to lahko počnemo redno, pa bo baterija še vedno zdržala, to zdaj res pomeni neko novo dimenzijo elektromobilnosti, ker nam to omogoča, da bomo lahko tudi v električni dobi šli na današnji bencinski servis in se oskrbeli z energijo. Seveda, megavatne polnilnice so šele prihodnost.
We are working together in a joint venture with our competitors, in this case Volvo and Traton. And we actually came together because we saw that, you know, someone has to take a step forward to make sure that we start to build infrastructure for heavy-duty trucks. And we invested 177 million each, which for a total 500 million. And the plan is to build 1,700 charge points by 2027.
Zgradili bodo torej 1700 megavatnih polnilnic, ampak električni tovornjakari bodo počivališča s temi polnilnicami obiskovali bolj zaradi kave in tuša, kot pa zaradi elektrike. Razumljivo, ker bo to kvarilo dobičkonosnost posla.
We do see that the lower operating cost for many customers actually compensate the higher purchasing price. So for many it will make sense to switch right away.
For your depot, you have to find the right charger that fits for your demands. If you have an 8-hour shift break in between and you charge it in half an hour, it would be parked 7.5 hours, it costs only money. So maybe 100K charger is okay, maybe 200, maybe only 50.
Počasno tovornjaško polnjenje je seveda še vedno hitro avtomobilsko polnjenje, a poanta je predvsem v ceni elektrike.
So 5 years the customer in France drives 120,000 kilometers. And actually our French customer, with the prices that we just got from the crowd, will save 37,000 euros over 5 years of lifetime. The data that we have here for Germany, as I said, it's 1.65 euro for diesel and 24 cents for electricity. And our German customer operating the eActros 600 in Germany will save approximately 89,000 or 90,000 euros over 5 years. Again, we agree there's going to be one customer who has this kind of like pricing, but there's going to be a million different customers who have different other pricings. But what is important is that each customer, so to speak, comes to that number and figures out what the difference is only in energy pricing to have an idea what the potential savings could be.
A to še ni vse. Prihranke najdemo tudi pri cestninah. Poglejmo primer Nemčija.
The German toll system will change on the 1st of December. For long haul trucks, 1 kilometer on the highway will be around 35 cents per kilometer. For diesel trucks. And this will start in 2 months. Maximal 25% of the diesel toll will be in the future the e-mobility toll. That means in 2026, we will start, the number is already given, with 5 cents per kilometer for eActros 600. This is fixed by the government. And we will have a difference of 30 cents per kilometer. And the, by law, we have the gap of 75%. So when we in the future say we will rise up E, we will rise also up E the diesel. This gap of 75% road tax will stay.
Cena elektrike je tako v industrijskih kot v zasebnih primerih neposredno povezana z razpoložljivostjo elektrike v omrežju. In prav to dejstvo že zdaj ob začetku električnega tovornega prometa odpira pot tudi tehnologiji, ki omogoča ne samo 500, ampak 1000 kilometrske dosege tovornjakov.
When the wind is blowing and you're producing a lot of electricity, sometimes you get to the point that it doesn't cost anything. And of course, I think this is also a point for hydrogen, because that electricity could actually be used to produce hydrogen. I mean, you cannot store electricity unless you put it in a battery, but that's not really feasible. And that's why I believe you can use the electricity to also make hydrogen. It's not a very efficient thing, because you lose kind of efficiency in the steps, but if you anyway have excess electricity, why not make hydrogen? That's a molecule, and you can save the energy in that molecule, and then you could potentially fuel a truck with hydrogen.
Naj gre za elektriko ali pa za vodik, pri obeh tehnologijah je cena vozila samo en del izredno velike investicije.
We have, of course, operating lease on the trucks, just as we have on conventional trucks. And on top of that, we are set up to also be able to finance the infrastructure investments for our customers. to do everything to make it as easy as possible for them to invest.
So I can get a leasing contract for 10 trucks directly with you available together with the charger.
Yeah.
Rekla je seveda, ampak električni avto, polnilnica, sončna elektrarna in zalogovnik na isti mesečni položnici, no to bi bilo zelo prikladno, če bi to ponujali tudi prodajalci avtomobilov v Sloveniji. Da to še ni običajno oziroma denarno smotrno, je menda razlog v rigidnosti slovenskih finančnih ustanov, ki ne zaupajo utrditve energetikov, tako pravijo avtomobilisti. Kdo ima prav? To naj se zmenijo sami, morajo pa razumeti nauk, ki se ga lahko naučimo od gospodarskega sektorja, da bomo lahko elektromobilnost množično uveljavili samo, če bomo imeli tehnologijo, ki nam finančno vzdržnost sploh lahko omogoči. In baterije v tem novem električnem aktrusu bi utegnile imeti bistveno širši vpliv, ne samo na gospodarski sektor. O to nas je prepričal tudi glavni CETL-ov inženir. Intervju z njim naj bo zdaj vaš naslednji klik.